Natural Beauties, thank you guys again for tuning in to NaturallyK. This is my section. I'm going to show you how I reach my chair. So some of the tools you're going to need is a staple gun, a screwdriver, staple remover, paint if you plan on painting the chair, your choice of fabric, a pair of scissors, and possibly a razor blade. So first here you see me using my screwdriver. I am going to remove the cushion from the base of the chair. Okay, so now that that's done, it's time to remove the fabric from the back of the chair. And excuse my little house slippers on, you guys. I started doing this the first thing in the morning, so yes, I have my little pink house slippers on, but I do. Okay, so basically the reason why I'm using the razor is because I am separating the fabric from the trim. And this was just the easier method for me. You could possibly just go ahead and use your heavy duty staple remover and remove the trim, but I wanted to try to save the cushions. So this was just the easiest way for me to do that, to preserve and save the cushion. Now it's time to tackle the trim and to remove all of the staples. I'm not going to lie to you guys, this is the most time consuming part when you're doing refurbishing, is to remove all the staples. There is at least, it feels like 1,000 staples in the chair. So once you kind of get the trim loosened up and you get a few staples removed, it does go a lot faster and a lot easier just to be able to tug on the trim a little bit and then remove the staple and just keep going down to remove the staple. So that's what you'll kind of see me doing, playing with it a little bit, trying to get a little bit loose. Next, it's time to paint the chair. I went with a white color because my fabric is white and gray, and you guys will be seeing me doing a lot more DIY things because I'm actually doing my living room, and that's basically the main colors, white and gray. So I'm just gonna go ahead and start painting the chair. If you have any rough patches or anything like that, definitely sand those down first so that way now while my paint is drying, where I have my freaking coat, I am going to go again with my heavy-duty staple remover, and I'm going to remove the fabric from the cushion of the chair. This black cover that you see here, that is what you call batting. I put it back onto my first chair, but I really don't like it. It's supposed to make it more sturdy or give it a cleaner finish. I'm probably going to be removing it off of that chair. I don't really see the need for batting for this particular DIY. Fabric I purchased from Walmart. I got 3 yards, which you probably need like 2 yards of fabric, honestly, but I just like to have extra just in case I feel like doing some throw pillows or anything else. Okay, the most important thing when you are doing print, if this is your first time, I definitely don't recommend you do print. I recommend you do a plain fabric, because when you're doing print, you have to make sure that it lines up on your chair straight, in straight lines, in straight vertical lines, your print, that's how it needs to be. Because once you turn it over, if you didn't line it up right, you're gonna have to take it all off and redo it again. So if you're a beginner, definitely do plain print until, or definitely don't do a print at all until you got it down pat. But I am doing print, and I made sure when I laid it out that it's straight and it lines up straight with my cushion. And now I'm just cutting off all the excess fabric. You do not need to pull it all the way up to the center of the back. You only need to pull it up maybe about an inch to an inch and a half to the back of the chair. The reason why you are doing that is because if you have too much fabric in the back, it's going to be too loose once you flip it over. So the less fabric that you have to pull over, the tighter it will be. The corners are also very important. You want to make sure, as you see I'm playing around with it, I'm trying to fold it and pull it. You definitely want to make sure that you grab as much fabric as possible in the corners, and you want to pull that in, pull it, and staple it at the same time. Your corners have to be tight. That also helps it give it that real flat, nice finish once you flip your fabric, once you flip, your cushion over. So now that my cushion is done, I am going to grab my foam again that was already under the chair. Some people like to go ahead and grab new foam. I just did some money saver, use the same foam, it's all right. As you can also see, I left the batting on the chair as well. I didn't see the need to remove it because I didn't plan on replacing the batting, and no paint really got on it, so it's fine. So right now I'm just trying to align the foam, put it back to where it was, so that way I can go ahead and throw my fabric over that. Again, you guys, this part is very important. Of course I edited it and everything like that, but this part did take me a little minute because you do have to make sure that your fabric is aligned with the cushion. You want to make sure that your print, whatever way you want it to go, it needs to match the cushion. So that's what I did here. As you can see, I made sure it's straight and centered. So we're good to go. We're good to go on to the next step. For this particular chair, I am not doing trim. Honestly, you guys, I'm not experienced really with doing trim that well. And I didn't like the trim when it was done on the chair previously, so I decided to try it without trim. So all I'm doing is I'm tucking the fabric under the cushion for the foam, and then I'm going to kind of pull the fabric so that way it's flat. And I'm just going to use my heavy duty staple gun and staple the fabric to the wood. The biggest thing that you want to keep in mind is you want to pull your fabric, tuck it under as tight as you can. So you'll see me playing around with it a little bit just to make sure I have it really tight. And of course, again, just like what I did with the cushion, I trimmed off all the extra fabric and I tucked it under, pull it under the cushion, make sure that the cushion is laying flat on the chair, and then I'm going to staple the excess fabric into the wood. As I'm finishing up the chair, the back of the chair was a little bit tricky because it, as you can see, has that curve. So you have to really pull the fabric to get it lay flat, pull it to go along with that curve. So I did a little bit more staples in that just to make sure it's flat in the chair. But it's the same method. You tuck the fabric under the wall and you staple that a little bit of excess fabric out. And you staple that into Okay, you guys, so as I finish up with the chair, I'm just going to take the cushion, place it on top, make sure that my print lines up with the cushion. And then for the bottom cushion, remember it was screwed in, so I just have to go under, mark those holes as to where the screws go, place the screws back in, and the chair is as good as new. Thank you guys for watching. If you like this video, you want to see more of my DIY things, please like, hit the like button. Please subscribe. Please comment below if you have any questions. I really, really appreciate you guys watching, and stay tuned for more.